We are going to study fifth chapter from democratic politics, that is political parties. What are political parties? A political party is a group of people who come together to contest elections. So their primary aim of a political party is to contest for the elections, thus hold power. They agree on some policies and programs for a society with a view to promote collective goodness. So a political party is a group of people who come together to contest elections and hold power. They have three main components. One, the leader. Second, the active members. And third, the followers or the supporters. They are also called as the followers too. Now you can notice here, without any of this, a political party simply cannot exist. They need to have the leader, active members and supporters. Why do you need a political party? If there was no political party, then each and every candidate would be independent. You agree with it, right? Current strength of the Lok Sabha is 543. Imagine a situation where none of the 543 members can be brought to think alike on a particular issue. This would lead to a total chaos. An independent candidate would always be more interested in the specific needs of his constituency, and he would not think about the larger interest of the nation. A political party is necessary to bring diverse people on a common platform so that the bigger issues can be taken care of. Now, the democracy which is being practiced all over the world is called representative democracy. What is representative democracy? In this system, governance is done through people's representative, because it is impossible for each citizen to directly participate. We cannot directly participate, so we elect one of our own as the representative. Thus he goes and represents our demands. So the need of representative democracy has given rise to political parties. What does a political party do other than asking for votes, as you see in here? Contesting elections. A political parties contest elections. A political party nominates its candidate for the electoral contest in various constituencies. So that's the first one. Policies, making policy. Political parties put forward different policies and programs so that the voters can choose from them. A political party brings a larger number of similar opinions under one umbrella. These opinions are channelized to form policies and programs. The policies and the programs of the ruling party are expected to be followed by the government. Now, if you think that any policy or the programs that a ruling party makes, it actually makes it for the people from which it got elected, right? I'm just highlighting some of the important terms here so that it will be easier for you to understand. The third one is obviously the making the law. What will the political party do is it plays a decisive role in making the law for the country. You may be aware that the legislature, which passes a law after proper debate, the member belonging to a political party has a direct say. He will debate either for the law or against the law. He will think about the advantages and disadvantages of the law. Then it becomes a law when they debate about it. The fourth one is formation of government. Political parties form and run the government. They form the government as soon as the elections are over. If they have majority, they claim their right to form the government. They run the government for 5 years. The executive body is formed by people from the ruling party. Various political leaders are assigned different ministries. They become different ministries under the cabinet. They meet under the chairmanship of the prime minister to carry out the task of governance. Now, if a party does not get, let's say if the party does not get majority, in that case, the party plays the role of opposition. It becomes an opposition party. As much as a ruling party is required, the opposition party is also required in an active democracy. Because it plays the role of the watchdog, the opposition party, if it is strong, can condemn, criticize and support the government. So we need to have a stronger opposition as well. Now, shaping public opinion. Political parties shape public opinion. They do so by raising and highlighting issues, whether it can be in the legislature or in the media. Now, if you have seen our people, the representatives chosen by us go to the media or in the assembly, they put forward the problems that his or her constituency people face. The last one is access to government machinery and welfare schemes. The government makes a lot of welfare schemes which is targeted at the people. So the political parties provide people an access to the government machinery. Machinery means not the physical machinery, it means working, and welfare schemes, since it is easy to approach local party leader than the government officers. You might have seen this a very common thing where people do not go to the officers, they just call the political leaders and get themselves the work done. Functions of the political party is important for 5 marks. Remember, different party systems. Now, in some countries, only one party is allowed to control and run the government. These are called one party system. In China, obviously, China is a democratic country. To the outset, it is not a democratic country actually in practice, but they have only one party, that is the Communist Party. You have studied it in What is Democracy and Why Democracy in class 9. Two-party system. In some countries, power is shared between two main parties. Such party system is called two-party or else called as bi-party system. The United States of America and the United Kingdom. The United Kingdom has a Conservative Party, the Labour Party. The US has the Republic Party and the Democratic Party. Third system is multi-party system, where several parties compete for power and more than two parties have reasonable chance of winning. We call it as a multi-party system. In India, we have a multi-party system. The number of parties in India is probably more than 700. Since multi-party system tend to offer more choices to the voters, it is often considered better than the other party systems. Now, we will debate on that one. Now, let's say comparison between two party and a multiple party. Two party, you will have similar choice. Either you have to vote for A party or B party, right? Whereas here, you have many choices. If you have, let us say, a constituency where you have representatives from different parties, there will be nearly 5 to 6 party people standing. So that provides you with many choices. This provides for stable governance because there are only two parties, either that party or this party will come into power. Whereas here, it's not stable. The two-party systems are not as flexible because they have more or less rigid set of opinions on every issue. In US and UK, you might be seeing the recent ongoing crisis in the United States. A multi-party system is more responsive to a change or shift in public opinion like India. Because India is a diverse country, the multi-party system is obviously supported in a country with huge population. Now let's go to a different type of category, that is a national party and a regional party. Now if you see here, the national party, a party that secures at least 6% of the total votes in Lok Sabha or assembly election. Remember, it is 6%, right? Then 6% in 4 states. This number is obviously asked for MCQs. Or at least 4 seats in the Lok Sabha. 6% of the total votes or 4 seats, right? Now here the election commission has decided that a national party shall be eligible to recognized as a national party if it secures 6% in any 4 states or the state legislative assembly, and in addition it wins at least 4 seats in the house of the people, that is the parliamentary elections, or at least 2% seats in the house of the people. Okay, let's not get here, we'll just take this one. This I'll keep it as option because it will go, it's going to create confusions. So we'll go for the first and the second point. Now these are the recognized national parties in India. There are so many parties. Remember those because it is going to come handy to you. The BJP, Bharatiya Janata Party, which is now the ruling party led by the leader Amit Shah. Indian National Congress. Now it's not Amit Shah. It is changed. It has changed. The Indian National Congress, now led by Sonia Gandhi. Communist Party of India. Communist Party of India. Marxist. Bahujan Samajwadi Party, Nationalist Congress Party, or else called as the NCP. Now pause this video and look at their symbol, foundation year, and their leaders. We are going to look at this in detail. State parties. Now a state party secures 6% of the votes again in an election for Vidhan Sabha, or at least win 2 seats. This is fairly easy. They have to win 2 seats or secure 6% of the votes in the legislative assembly. Now here I had got it from somewhere, the source. So again, this point I'll take it as a no. You can go into first and two. Now recognize state parties in India. There are so many parties. You can see this picture here, the cartoon here. Obviously it is person Mr. You know it, you can comment down in the comment box. Aam Aadmi Party, All India Anna Dravida Munnetra Kalagam, All India Forward Block, All India Majlis E Ittehadul Muslimin, All India NR Congress, All India Trinamool Congress, All India United Democratic Front. These parties are important because one of the board, one of the years in the board exam, they asked about the political parties in the state, that are the regional parties, their symbol and their state. These were asked, so I would say give it a good reading. Now obviously again there is another cartoon. If you know about this, please comment in the comment box. What is the issue? Why are they sitting on a cow, which is actually a skeleton of a cow, and why is he feeding grass to it? These are the parties, very famous parties. I will recollect those parties when I will teach the whole of India. So you can pause the video or else it is there in the textbook as well. Now I'll take a quote here, then I'll move forward. If men be good, government cannot be bad. The government is good because the men will be good. So we cannot blame the government, it's the men we should blame, right? We'll move on with this one. Now we are going to study about national parties, few of the national parties in detail. It is going to come for 3 marks short note, or maybe 5 marks also. Now we're going to start with the oldest party in India, that is the Indian National Congress, founded obviously in 1885. Right. founded in 1885 by the members of the occultist movement of Theosophical Society, A.O. Hume, Dadabhai Nauroji, Dinshaw Vacha, Umesh Chandra Banerjee, Surendranath Banerjee, Manmohan Ghose, and Mahadev Govind Ranade, M.G. Ranade. These were the founding members of the Indian National Congress. It played an important role in the independence of India. You have studied in this chapter 2. It was a ruling party till 1977 after independence. What happened after that you might be knowing. I require you to comment in the comment box. A centrist party in its ideological orientation. It espouses secularism. The idea, main idea of Congress is secularism and welfare of weaker sections. Currently, it leads the ruling United Progressive Alliance. Now it is in the opposition party. The party's political symbol is hand. Now, Prime Minister of the Republic of India from the Indian National Congress. These are the Prime Ministers who were from the INC who have become the Prime Ministers of the Republic of India. Jawaharlal Nehru, followed by Gulzarilal Nanda, Lal Bahadur Shastri, Indira Gandhi, Rajiv Gandhi, P.V. Narasimha Rao and Manmohan Singh was the recent one in 2014, the power change to the Bharatiya Janata Party. Now, these are the prominent members from the Indian National Congress. Gandhi also associated himself with the Indian National Congress, but however, he did not have any position in the party. The one time he presided the Indian National Congress was in 1924 in the Belgaum Congress session held in Karnataka, Belgaum. The next major party we are going to study is Bharatiya Janata Party, that's called as BJP. BJP is the current form of what was called as Bharatiya Jansangha, which was founded in October 21, 1951 by Shyam Prasad Mukherjee, S.P. Mukherjee. They believe in Indian nationalism, that is Hindu nationalism, integral humanism, economic liberalism, Gandhian socialism, conservatism and social conservatism. The whole idea of this BJP is the central agenda is Hindutva. They came to power in 1998 as the leader of the National Democratic Alliance. You have heard about the Congress leading the United Progressive Alliance, the UPA, whereas the BJP leads the alliance called the NDA, National Democratic Alliance. Earlier limited to the northern and the western part, now it is also in the southern part. It is ruling in the state of